lane as well with Lawton X Special, who haven't been able to click very well so far this year, but that game, it definitely worked.
Certainly did, as teams will swap sides for game two's draft. We'll see what changes here as far as picks and bans go. Ryze first ban consistent across these two games, at least for FlyQuest. Yep. There's a Jace ban for Dignitas though, mostly targeting high, but of course Balls showing us that he's maybe a little more willing to play carries.
Absolutely, the Jace ban as well as the Camille ban have been completely consistent across both of these games. Now the even the teams banning them, I think, is somewhat consistent. FlyQuest banned Camille on red side and now banning it on blue side. They have not shown an ability to play that champion even before the nerfs right now, so I can see why they are banning it. They're not wanting to give it someday.
Varus banned by Dignitas again, though, so interesting to see a lot of the same things here. Here's an adaptation, though. FlyQuest banning out Graves. I feel like he's such a good jungler. You could first pick it, but not wanting to take that risk here. And there's Shen banned by Dignitas, so kind of the same two power picks from last patch left open. Lwanka and Rengar, and Moon just takes it again.
Yeah, and remember last game, the Rengar was taken, but the LeBlanc was just left up. So neither of the guys really wanted to play LeBlanc. High has counter picks for it even before the nerfs. Clearly wanted to do the Jarvan instead of a LeBlanc into his Ed. And I believe the Shen ban is just because Team Dignitas actually sees that as the premier top laner outside of Maokai, who, by the way, is now somebody's ninth game on Maokai.
Yep.
So his most played top laner by a wide margin.
Gonna take that here, and there's Jhin away from Altak into the hands of Lod, which is even better with Varus banned away. So interesting to see a lot of shifts here. It feels like a lot of those top champions are now starting to eat bans now that a lot of the must ban champions have kind of fallen down. Like you said, LeBlanc, I expect her to drop through the draft again, although here's the Rumble for Balls. Was banned last game by Dignitas.
Yeah, another game and another game where Balls is not playing a tank. So his second non-tank game of the year, plus second in a row. Been a long time Rumble player. It's a pretty good matchup into Maokai as long as you don't fall behind. And it will aid FlyQuest in going all in. Throwing down an equalizer while Rengar jumps in is a very efficient way to initiate.
And there's Malzahar as well for elimination. So taking one of his most consistent picks here. Champion that did drop through completely with Rengar and Graves picked up. Kha'Zix did receive some nerfs, but I think still good given the available jungle pool.
Yeah, and it are non-trivial nerfs to Kha'Zix as well. Reduction of his attack damage ratio on Q, as well as the cooldown refund you get from evolving it, are both down. So not as great at bursting as beforehand, as most times when you jump on a squishy, you're kind of waiting on your second cycle of Q before you'd actually finish them off. Still a strong pick though, and I'm expecting a W evolution fairly soon.
Well, there's Misfortune banned by Dignitas, so probably looking at Altak actually with Malzahar pick, gonna take that AD carry away.
Yeah.
We'll see what FlyQuest want to do with their two bans here. Team's getting a little less cute than the last time, although we'll see what happens in the second phase of picks.
Yeah, and I mean, if one thing, even though Kopp hasn't found the most success from a win-loss perspective as a coach in his career, I've always liked his drafts. He seems to think fairly far ahead, knows what the other team is strong at, and is just making sure that they can't pull off that Misfortune Malzahar lane, where as soon as they hit six, they press all their buttons and get a kill.
And I think illuminating for me to hear Kopp say, you know, I haven't been with a team that long, and my issue is that I don't know the players well enough yet. Clearly a coach that understands that draft isn't just about picking the best champions, it's about picking what's best for your players as well.
Exactly. I did get to talk to him beforehand, though, and he did say he still knows what's good. So he's still fairly confident in this. He says his Korean players know all the meta picks, so that's not necessarily a problem, and that he just needs to make sure he can pick around the rest of the team to find the strong comps.
Well, LeBlanc ban for Dignitas, so that will not be an option here for FlyQuest. Karma was their first ban, which is a curious one. I'm kind of expecting a Thresh ban, to be honest, given the pattern that FlyQuest are banning out, but maybe they think Zyra is just a little too important, and Cassio is actually the other ban here, so maybe protecting High's future pick.
Yeah, some definitely curious bans coming through in very defined targets. Definitely feels like Team Dignitas having to pick around Keen a little bit, definitely not wanting the LeBlanc, or being forced into a pick that needs to be good against the Blanc. And I'm hoping that that enables a future pick that they're going for. Maybe more of a pick like Twisted Fate, where they've had some success with it earlier. Where they just go with Zed again?
Yeah, I mean, Zed blind. Okay. I think Keen had an exceptionally good Zed game in the last one, so he'll take it here again. Also has bad memories of the last time he played LeBlanc into FlyQuest, so you can kind of see why they want to shy away from it.
Yeah, I see that, but basically, they pick it this early because they're thinking that High is going to want to pick it blind since it works very well with Rumble for the diversified damage. The fear here, though, is if Zyra somehow were to go along the wayside and the FlyQuest team decided to put Malzahar mid lane, because then Team Gigatoss would not have an access to magic damage. But that's, I think, what they're banking on. I think the Zyra would be the final pick for Team Gigatoss, pending any changes.
Well, there's a Sivir for Altec, which is a pick that's seen some play, but I believe her first pick this year in the NALCS.
I believe Stixxay played it twice in a losing series earlier, but I agree with you. It's something we're probably going to see a little bit more of as Varus moves towards more of a permaban status and Ashe becomes less appealing due to the fact that she needs to go for the crit build. So I do feel like the late game scaling as well as the ability to shove for Sivir pretty strong.
Well, here's the run back from FlyQuest. Going to take Jarvan into the Zed again, and I think Zyra going to complete the comp. It's really interesting that Dignitas just did this in this order rather than the order you described previously. But
yeah,
like you said, I think just expecting Hyde to take it if it's up and probably confident that Keen doesn't play Jarvan.
Yeah, and they were not punished pretty much at all, it feels like. As long as they're comfortable with the Zed versus Jarvan matchup, this seems like, as you said, the run back for Hyde and Keen both saying, you know what, I was able to win that Zed matchup. I don't want to play it into the block, by the way. Just going to throw that in there, even though you had a chance to do a last game, thinking that maybe Hyde would go for the LeBlanc if they did it again. But instead, we get to see same matchup top lane and different matchups everywhere else.
I like the changes for FlyQuest. I mean, I think the theory of the comp is very similar. In fact, their top half is almost identical. Rumble is a pretty like replacement for Vladimir as far as what he wants to do. Bit of extra range. Doesn't need to get quite as involved. But the look seems quite similar. Sivir's nice addition, though. They definitely have problems getting in together or diving, so Sivir should supplement a lot of that.
Yeah, so for FlyQuest, still a lot of initiation. Team Dignitas have good counter initiation with the Zyra, so those bans that were thrown out, like the Cassiopeia by FlyQuest right at the end, and not blocking that Zyra in any way, shape, or form, I think you can actually be a little bit critical of that FlyQuest draft, but keep in mind, Zyra, another champion, had some minor nerfs. You actually have to land your spells in order to get the plants to acquire champions with your first auto attacks. Still a strong counter engage champion, though, in my opinion.
Yeah, and the other side is I think Maokai's a huge problem for FlyQuest team comp as well. So they're probably banking on balls and maybe with a bit of help from Moon having a strong laning phase to keep the Maokai down. Impact was able to play a difficult counter matchup and win it on the Maokai side. We'll see how balls and his very well-known Rumble does in game number two. FlyQuest down one here. Gonna have to win this one if they're gonna try and tie it up and continue a very good looking record. Dignitas on the other side though, huge opportunity here. New patch, new coach, a lot of changes for this team. Could be a fresh start for them and really kick themselves with a bit of extra momentum going into what is now effectively the second half of the season.
Yeah, it's going to be, this is the final game for them in their first round robin, so to speak. Team Dignitas, like you mentioned, was looking pretty abysmal, but coming up strong against FlyQuest would completely kind of throw your expectations around. The team compositions, as you mentioned, match up somewhat similarly to last game. And if they can counter FlyQuest dives the same way, that could be serious.
Well, another quick note, Xspecial, of course, still on assist watch. 3 kills to go for a career record and an LCS record, actually, of 2,000 assists. Not off to a good start, though. Lamination getting aggressive there in the bottom lane, but he'll be okay for now.
Yeah, it's hard to imagine not getting 3 assists in this game after he got so many in the last one, especially with the pace and reckless abandon that FlyQuest have with their dives.
Well, Lod pacing back and forth here. Xspecial sitting firmly in his own tri-bush, wanting to not get any more aggression from the nation. And he's chasing with a bit of assistance from Someday. Setting up some saplings, should have a quick start on the Raptors. Someday not helping with extra leashing though, so no major buff start here for Chaser.
Yeah, super interesting actually. Both junglers starting Raptors is becoming a more popular start for people who think they can do it because there's more experience in this camp. Notice they actually get more than level 2 if you look at the experience bar down in the bottom left right there from Raptors. So both guys with identical starts. Moon takes a little bit more harass obviously because the pull is not as great as 3 Maokai saplings.
Well, with that we are going to go back down to Freak and a little more insight after this second game.
Thanks very much, Pastry. Talked with Kopp this time, the new coach for Team Dignitas, and asked him how he felt about the kind of an upset game 1 win. And he said everyone else on the team was super happy, everyone you know backstage, but he was just stone-faced and said, it's all about game 2. I'll be after the series. So he's very focused on making sure they can close the one out. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Freak. It makes sense. I mean, Kopp doing, I think, the correct coach thing, putting on the brave face and saying, it's all about winning the series here. We'll see if Dignitas can do that. Ooh, good flash by Someday following in. Balls actually should be dead here. Isolation is enough, and there's first blood for the Kha'Zix.
And the timing of that gank definitely caught Balls a little bit off guard. you're level two in lane. Oftentimes, Maokai doesn't even have Twisted Advanced skilled at level two. He had E and W skilled on that, so not even a Q. So obviously he was getting shoved in by Rumble. And then the timing on the flash was just not there for Balls. Right after the Twisted Advanced started, Someday was able to follow. And then also, he isolated himself by flashing out of the minion wave to make the kill fairly easy. And what a good start.
Oh, especially with the fake tech. Moon misses the Bullock. Special flashes out. Cannot afford those mistakes.
That little execution stuff need to be better. Moon was in position, and if he lands that bola, there's a good chance he actually kills that special, but he lets him out.
Wow. I mean, such a random position to be in as well. Moon showing great presence of mind as a jungler. That's twice now he's been in the absolute correct place, which never feels like the right one with the first gank in top lane, and now that Tri-Bush camp there in bottom side. But bit of a mess up could have cost him a kill there, and FlyQuest will start behind again as Dignitas get themselves first blood. Certainly expected attention towards that top lane. Chaser with the good gank timing and Balls. We'll see if he can continue to press an advantage now that Someday got that early assist gold.
Yeah, I completely agree. Watching that one more time, X-Special really didn't expect someone to be in that tri-brush. He was actually walking that way so he could ward over the wall to the river. So Moon was way ahead of that, but he leaped past what his bowler range was going to be and shot it right past him.
Well, good news there. Hi though, continuing to get the early push in. We saw this in game number one in this matchup. Jarvan is expected to win early and often. Keen doing what he can, farming up from range, but Hi every chance he gets. Going for the harass, and Thunderlord's Jarvan is awfully good.
Yeah, with the Corruption Potion as well, he's got pretty good sustain, not to mention he needs to keep that mana up since he's wave clearing and harassing with his EQ.
Maximum early game though for Hi as Keen is going to play it safe. We'll see if anyone from Dig comes for another visit, or if Hi can maybe play a little cleaner on the all-in. Almost got Keen in the last game. We'll see if he can convert properly for the 1v1 kill. Although I think Keen is pretty acutely aware of that happening, so should be playing it safe as Chaser takes the left side scuttle and just checks to see what's happening at top lane. Wants to make sure Someday's okay through the tough part of the matchup.
For sure, and there's a very small window in which Hi can actually get that all-in, because if Keen hits level 6, he can oftentimes dodge the Cataclysm damage with his own ultimate and kind of turn it in Zed's favor, so Hi needs to hit level 6 first. Cheeky gank here by Chaser. Balls' flash is already down. Someday has flash, so all they'd have to do is get a flash Twisted Advance onto him and potentially get a kill, but they don't want to get too aggressive because the chance of a counter gank is very real, and even at level 5, his damage is high. There it is.
Someday flashes in. Balls in trouble again. Should be another kill. Balls, crap shield on, but not enough. Someday gets that kill.
And also, while that was happening, we're going to have to take another look in the mid lane. Keen burned his Ignite and flashed towards Hi, and Hi ended up flashing back to safety. So things really going in Team Dignitas's favor. Someday was down in lane last time. They are really punishing Balls this game on Rumble. Watch the mid lane one more time here. Let's see. He queues in, and it's actually Keen who just gets aggressive. Hi just popping his W shield and barely living through, but Keen definitely trying to turn that lane in his favor.
Smart from Keen. Had a very narrow window to try and get a kill, and would have gotten it if Hi didn't have the foresight to shield up and be safe. So all of Dignitas, seems like everyone's kind of sharpened up after game one. They'll certainly feel emboldened after a strong game one win. If they can bring it home nicely here with a sweep, says a lot about Dignitas, who are looking for that late push. FlyQuest starting to maybe see some weaknesses in their overall style. It was so good for the first half, but yeah. I think a tough loss to Cloud9, maybe showing some of their weak points here. And even again, this type of draft just feels very narrow, and FlyQuest might need to show a little more versatility in the back half of the season.
Exactly, and you look at a team like FlyQuest having so many doubters coming into the year, and they really just wanted to prove people wrong early on, but they've actually just been getting a ton of praise and accolades in the last few weeks, since they are now a top two team and they had such a close series against Cloud9, but a lot of times it can be kind of deflating after you have a hyped up matchup like that, knowing they're playing TSM later this week. You can see them with Team Dignitas just making coaching change, not taking it seriously.
X-Special forces Lemon Nation to flash, so good attempt there from Lemon Nation. Not level 6, so couldn't really complete an all-in, but Chaser right behind his support as well. I'm still pushing up, looking for something as Ball's forced to play very far back. You can see already how much the lane matchup has turned around with Chaser showing those two early spots of attention.
Definitely. Chaser doing huge work for Someday in this lane. And just to get back to FlyQuest, it's not that they're not taking it seriously against FlyQuest, but it is that they're preparing for other matches or have their mind elsewhere and just aren't expecting Team Dignitas to look so clean. Meanwhile, Team Dignitas kind of had a wake-up call with the coaching change, and while Kopp can't make any huge changes in 2 days, the mentality could bring to the rest of the team could help. That's a nice roam, though, from
Special, I think. Dad, yeah, Moon takes him out. Lod forced to flash. Gets himself out, but he couldn't save his support.
Oh, man, just a perfect roam. As I was talking about how FlyQuest was slumping and Dignitas was coming back, High had the window in the lane to jump up. They have the level 6 from Moon. They also teleport defensively with Rumble, who probably didn't even have to complete that, but does to have all 5 of FlyQuest down there. But since somebody teleported in anyway, there's no pressure elsewhere for Team Dignitas. Beautiful play by FlyQuest.
And that's a big recall for Fly as well, getting themselves that extra burst of gold from the first turret. No one after the Mountain Drake, interestingly. Maybe Dignitas could have had a window there to take it, but instead, we'll watch this again. Especially when Lod tried to get out of this.
Yeah, they knew that something was on the way, but that little move by Expecial towards the end, thinking, I wonder if they're... No, you don't have to wonder if they're there. Stay on the right side of the lane, run in the brush, keep your maximum distance away, and then what actually happened is because Expecial tweaked inwards a little bit, Lod got caught by the very end of the Cataclysm and pulled back. So that is something that I think they still could have avoided if they had been a little bit more alert and flashed earlier slash hugged the wall.
Yeah, missed the end there a bit. Blue buff over to Kane. High, trying to keep the minions out from under the turret. Looking good so far with the early roams. Just more of the style we expected from him in game one with the drive. And I think Kane has shown that he's perfectly fine in the counter matchup. So should be able to demonstrate that, okay, High, I'm not going to get a 1v1 kill, especially at this point. So if I can leave them and influence the side lanes, that's really where High can start to shine on this pick.
Yeah, and Moon actually taking a little tour through the jungle. Nice hop over the Krugs to escape, because I feel like Team Dignitas is collapsing on him.
Yeah, good rotation there from Fly, actually, trying to take a turret down. But Dignitas reads that well, moves their duo lane up to their that spot also. And FlyQuest don't have enough resources or vision to commit to a stronger push, and Dignitas, we can see, are in the area. So smart play there from FlyQuest, wanting to give it time before moving back to the wave. They do need a turret here. That's gold that they'll like to have, but Dignitas are not going to make it easy.
Yeah, and I actually feel like Team Dignitas is just kind of forfeiting the turret advantage over to FlyQuest. They could not match the turret for turret trade, and now it's of utmost importance that they keep Lod and Expecial in the safety of a turret, just due to the threat of a repeat gank from Jarvan and Rengar. It's the same jungle mid high moon combo that we saw in game one. It's just this game, it has a much higher chance of working since it's already worked, and there's a duo lane that is super squishy without flash on their AD.
Blue buff for High here. He's actually gonna give up the cannon. Gets a couple creeps with his E, but takes them down. Turret's not gonna take too much damage though, so he'll collect almost everything else. He's now gonna have a lot of extra mana to work with. Keen though, sorry, has finished his Ghost Blade already, so they're already off the start he needs. One of the nice things about lethality items, they're very cost efficient.
Off to the races there for Keen for sure, and High's trying to get his advantages from roaming even. Keen even has the Ignite advantage right now, so High would have to be fairly careful, especially with Someday kind of just roaming around the map since he is in the lane without a turret that is pushed to Ball's side right now. So the rest of FlyQuest have to be very careful because Maokai could kind of be anywhere.
This is smart though from Moon. Again, looking to continue to pressure this turret. Lemonation also playing back. Ready with the ultimate. Flash is a few seconds away from being up as well, so Lod has to play awfully far back. Hyde is moving himself back over to his lane. He's aware that Keen is continually trying to push him in, but he wants to...
Oh, this is so close. Lemon could flash alt at pretty much any moment when Lod moves forward to the lane, and that's what they were hoping to see. And they're going back for it once again.
Lod not biting though. Gonna take the very safe way back down towards his teammates. And Lemon Nation might actually have to give it up here, hitting the recall button. You can see pings as well from Dignitas. They know that people have been waiting in that bush. Moon has not left the area yet either, so this is a long con to try and get a kill, and they want it.
Or just go through the turret.
Yeah, brute force instead. Gonna take the turret down. Smart zoning there. Moon actually gets his way out from under the W, but turret's gonna fall down. Gymbullet still launching in though. Tagged almost all four onto Moon, I believe.
The cost. Lemonation still has ultimate.
Ooh, doesn't quite get it. There's the plant. Expecial goes in, but he gets himself ultimated. Keen's up here as well, though. Should be able to play clean up. Expecial gets one for Lemonation. Now Moon getting dived on by Keen. Damage is there. The pop is good. Keen gets another. I'll take a look at the chase down. Chaser gets a double kill for himself, though.
And the rest of the cavalry's here. It's a 5v5 erupting. Teleport coming in from Someday.
Someday locks down high, looking to try and take him down, but Hyde's in the back already. Blows up Log with a combo. And now Keen and Altec fighting it up, but Keen's got no cooldowns to play with. Bolf burning down Someday on the top right. Altec gets the other kill, and Bolf wants to take out Someday. Someday with the flash as Bolf can flash as well. Harpoon's in for one, needs another. There's the second slow flame spinner in. Someday tries to turn and fight. Bolf needs a bit more, and he gets himself the kill.
And with all things considered, that is, I believe, 5 deaths for Team Dignitas in this dive. We're watching it one more time. Lemon X Special wanted to flash in for the root and an ultimate, but he couldn't get both casts off, so it's very delayed. He then doesn't get any knockups with the ultimate, and Keen takes a bunch of turret damage from that exchange. And then here, Chaser took the turret damage as well. Altec finishes it off, and this is where the 3v3 continues right here. Lod's cut off, so he wants to stay in this brush and at all costs avoid the EQ from Jarvan. But he roots himself essentially by trying to combo that W, which he missed, by the way. Then Hai's able to execute him. So the performance of these players throughout that fight definitely favored FlyQuest landing more skill shots to the missed ones from Team Dignitas and just getting the timings right. So outplays across the board there for FlyQuest.
Got the turret as well, and now 2-0 up in turrets, looking to snowball the game, which is what they couldn't get done on the other side of it. Special did get an assist in that exchange though, so that's good. He's 2 away now from 2,000. But Altec smashing in this game. 3 kills already on the Sivir. When I talked to him earlier in the season, he says, you know, I kind of want to play more carries, but utility is where it's at. Sivir is kind of a hybrid between the two, and he's showing up on this pick.
It really is, and it's only going to get better. You hear about the famed 500 CS Sivir win condition, and it's because when Sivir gets to 70% crit and 300 AD, and since the ricochet can crit, the team fighting is almost unmatched as far as actual carries. But the reason we can see Sivir sometimes is because you can shove out enough of the laning phase, especially against Jhin, who's spell-based since you have a spell shield, and survive that. So great start having 3-0, just kind of accelerating to that point on Sivir.
Yeah, you can see Mountain Drake over for FlyQuest. Dignitas traded the top outer turret for it. Is Lemon Nation off to play? Oh, yeah! Whoa! Pile wins, and that's a kill under Keen. Lemon Nation trapped by Someday will go down, but Someday gonna get dove by High Moon. There's a knockup, lands him for Jarvan, the double kill!
This is what High envisioned the last time he picked Jarvan. He's thinking, we're gonna be flashing over walls, diving turrets, and one-shotting people, and then even killing the tank, who has had to build spec against Rumble, so they're able to kill him with their 2 physical damage dealers down the stretch right there. What an aggressive play that Team Dignitas was not ready for, and it's a 2-for-1 for FlyQuest.
I saw Lemon Nation there, and I was like, there's no way he goes in for it. And then, within half a second, he's over the wall. I mean, I joke about it. Lemon Nation's Flash Ultimates have been on point all season long, and yep. This is maybe one of his best.
Well, this will help you win the Assassin versus Assassin matchup when the other guy gets suppressed at the start of it. But Someday's there, and you actually think it's going to turn around. Then you notice how Moon is actually relatively tanky on that Rengar and powers his W as an escape path, and High comes away with a double kill. So beautiful play by FlyQuest.
He joins Altec in the 3 kills club also, so the snowball that we didn't get to see is starting to roll down the mountain. FlyQuest good at getting themselves back into the game in the mid game, and really good when they have a lead. Altec though needs to dodge the plants, team.
Yeah.
Lemonation blocks the first, there's the second. Running out of the area, Altec safe.
Special the bro takes all 3. Malzahar should almost always take the first one because his spell shield will block it. Or rather, his super shield that basically blocks everything will stop it. Look out though for High.
Edge of Night channeled. High can't really 1v2, I don't think. In fact, Keen might finish him off solo. Chaser runs in. High gonna take a bit of extra poke. Oh, it's not enough. He goes back in. Oh, he wanted it so bad.
Nice play by Keen to just press E as High was jumping in and kind of avoid that potential cataclysm burst. High burning everything in an attempt to escape. And Keen only burning ultimate at Ignite. So Team Dignitas get one back, and despite the successes of FlyQuest with these roams, the game's still quite competitive.
Yeah, not really set up in the sidewaves there with that split push, so High, I think, too far forward. Chaser gonna take this Scuttle Crab. Mountain Drake's up in 3-4 minutes, so no objective to play with just yet, but certainly on the minds of both these teams is Altec all alone. 2v1 right now, although Chaser gonna hit the recall button. Altec just gonna clear out this wave and defend the turret. Chaser does complete the recall though, so Altec's safe.
Yeah, Altec making sure minions don't get anywhere close to that turret. Expect him to stay up around 10 CS per minute this game as long as they keep allowing him to clear the side lanes or give him the CS when he's in the mid lane. Balls is not being a bro there for all day, except for the last one.
It's busy. Like, we're still looking for the mid out of turret as well, so staying grouped around the center of the map. They've got good open spaces on either side to work with, but kind of need to crack the center to really open up the map for themselves. Dignitas did manage to get the top out of turret, but they've been behind on almost every objective play ever since that first dive from FlyQuest in the bottom lane. And this turret's not long for this well, just needs a little bit more work.
Teleport coming in from Team Dignitas, though, not wanting to give up this turret.
Sunday for the flank. Moon already caught up by Kane. Sunday trying to find a position, but they suppress Kane. He's going to go down to the Malzahar, and now Chaser exhausted. Looks to dive in for it. Sunday trying to tank shots, but he's already down 40% health. Good equalizer there by Ball, trying to cut off a lot of Sunday. Flash down, but Ball straight into the mix. Burns them all down. Lord gets the kill, but they're going to answer a few back.
So low!
Barely lives, and now Chaser gets the resets. Altac doesn't get hit by the other side. His Expecial cracks 2,000.
And that's the type of fight to get it for you. They get the turret down the stretch, but this is again turning into one of those really high-action games.
Here comes Altec with a 1v2.
Can he do it? I mean, does Team Dignitas want to go for it? Altec playing so aggressive out of mana.
Not now.
Gets them back by blocking the Deadly Flourish. We're going to get to see that fight once again.
Doesn't want it, though. Altec does play it safe. Out of turret, like you said, is over for FlyQuest, so things working out well. That looked disastrous for Dignitas when it started out, but...
Yeah. They got a lot of turn damage towards the end of this fight, and the Malzahar suppression is coming in so clutch for them until King gets a QSS, because watch this, it's just, he gets an E off before they can counter it and jump back on him. And then, while FlyQuest is caught up in the Zyra ultimate, that's one of the good things for them. The Rumble ultimate to cut them off seems genius, but right here, they get caught up by pretty much just Zyra roots, and also I think the Jhin trap ended up proccing on two of them, which allowed Chaser to come in at the end and pick up some kills. Very close fights, as we got a lot of squishy people in this game.
And that's kind of the fun part about it. 21 kills in already at 19 and a half minutes. Drake up in 45, Baron gonna join it actually earlier in 20 seconds now. High again, lining it up once Sunday. Here's the ultimate, balls as the equalizer ready to go. Misses the first harpoon, and now Chase is here to defend.
Did they keep going though? Rengar all popped.
Ultimate committed. Moon's gonna try and cut them off at the pass, but they're a little too late. Moon almost in position, but the rest
what's
of
it
here. Moon goes in for it once. Chaser, but Chaser leaps out. Expecial caught up on the other side though. He's gonna go down. Altec's the traitor's key. Shuts him down.
And FlyQuest is relentless with these dives. Even though Someday looked to repel the first one, FlyQuest recognized they could get more people to the spot before Team Dignitas could match, and they get a 2-for-1 as well as push this turret.
Lord looks for High. High gets out of the way. Moon tanking all the shots. King can finish him off. Doesn't get him. No, now King's caught out. Doidly's gonna chase him down. Elimination. Able to get that next kill. Someday not there in time.
And you can really see this game why Elimination prioritized Malzahar over Zyra and why so many teams banned Malzahar against him. The team just works so much better when he's on this champion. Watching this play, this is the continuation after already burning Sunday's flash in an earlier fight. Moon doesn't even jump on the Maokai because he knows Chaser is so squishy, but Expecial just supporting from the wrong angle. That's a play where he needs to be completely in the back. Keen is able to pick up Altec off the back end because they were kind of planning a counterattack, but doesn't necessarily work. Turret goes down and still a 2-for-1 for FlyQuest.
Yep, 4 turrets to 1 up in FlyQuest's favor. They've got the kill lead and the gold lead to boot. Mountain Drake now up and alive, so both teams could be looking to position themselves around that objective. Balls and Moon already there to the plate. Got to grab down and FlyQuest gonna start it. Dignitas, we saw them play pretty passive in the last game without opportunities. Gonna play this one a little slower as well, knowing that FlyQuest are ahead.
Yeah, and it's also much harder to engage on the team that has the Rumble and the Malzahar.
High, looking to make a highlight reel.
What?
Misses that Q. Keen, though, just defensively ultimating High. Does have his QSS now, does Keen, so Elimination's not gonna have nearly as juicy a target.
Super interesting, too, because that QSS really hurts his ability to duel the Jarvan, but really helps his ability in teamfights when he has to deal with the Malzahar, which I still feel like plays heavily into FlyQuest because as soon as High can beat Keen in the 1v1, the map pressure for Team Dignitas evaporates.
High peering out of ward. FlyQuest have lots of room to play with. And two Mountain Drakes means any sieges they do get started will end very favorably for them. In fact, Baron buff is looking awfully vulnerable with a third Mountain Drake on the way and the high damage composition of FlyQuest.
Exactly. Malzahar just makes it all the more easier because of the Voidling spam on top of Baron. And knowing it's a team with High, they make incredibly aggressive Baron calls, for better or worse, usually for the better. So Control Ward already in the pit, double upgraded sweepers on Moon and Lemon Nation. And I think that's where the game's going to turn now, Pastry Time. Whether or not they're doing the Baron, they're going to force Dignitas to stop.
Well, lots of control around the area, so FlyQuest in position. Control Ward's being littered across that portion of the map. And looks like Outtake is going to start shoving down mid. Got good damage on the Sivir. This turret undefended. Dignitas a little out of touch with that play. Take a big chunk of that turret's health as a result.
Yeah, and the interesting thing here is with Someday going for a recall, as he had an opportunity to get turret damage in, is there's not really a ward for him to teleport in on that is desirable. Probably the reason that he recalled, because he knew the Team Dignitas can't actually move up their ward line without Maokai there to prevent the initial initiation. So that's why Team Dignitas is kind of grouping his five right here. They're worried about the Baron. This is the Baron force the FlyQuest have been waiting for. Some days leading the pack, though, they're going on him.
Actually going to go Infrared. That's a good damage. He's actually going to evaporate by the looks of things, but it's for a little while longer, and the damage is back on the other side. Kane dives in to try and finish it off as Lod gets a couple snipes down. That's three kills for one now as Kane falls as Balls is the only sacrifice for FlyQuest. Very interesting fight. Lod still chasing. FlyQuest lost too much health, perhaps.
Yeah, and I almost feel like I feel bad for Someday in that one. He's walking in there. He knows the team needs him to clear vision. And then all of FlyQuest jump on him, and Team Dignitas is like, well, I guess they're going to kill you. That no, you fight. That's the whole reason he came there. It almost felt like they sacrificed Someday for very little gain. And eventually they lose the fight because they were so slow on the response right there, just getting picked off by FlyQuest.
Dignitas might get a turret at least. Hai is making his way swiftly back to the mid lane. But Lod and Chaser teams up and able to get that for themselves. Hai, though, still looking to go in. Doesn't have his Ghostblade for a little while longer. Teleporting from Balls is aggressive. Hai trying to close the distance. Balls had no ulti, so he just teleported into...
I was like, oh
scary.
Boy. Here comes a teleport. What's he going to flash over the wall? Go for him? No, he plain spits the wall. And the teleport is unfortunate. But they're going to keep this pressure up.
Altec ultimate, there's a special caught out. Goodbye, Altec. Able to take him out. Chaser gets the red buff, but Moon's chasing in. FlyQuest, 5v4, looking for the Baron.
Yeah, and Team Dignitas is out of sorts. We saw it with the slow follow-up the last time Someday was there. We saw it right there with Xpecial being forward while Wad was in the base. So FlyQuest is just going to keep farming kills on Team Dignitas until they hopefully hit critical mass. It is a high-pressure, high-speed style that FlyQuest and Hai in particular have been perfecting over the years. Now they force Baron, but they want to fight.
Well, you can see Hai at Lemon and the rest of FlyQuest just trying to bait Dignitas in. They'll start the Baron now. Well, it's going to get the ulti in there. Southling might give them a bit of extra vision, but the Baron's almost dead. Chaser going to get suppressed. They need to kill him before he gets it. Chaser gets
it!
He stole the Baron! And Dignitas now chasing in. Moon gets aggressed on his Outtake, being chased in by Kane. Almost dead. There's one for the Zed. Ball's going to get chased in as well. And there's a double kill for Kane. Oh, my God.
Team Dignitas come up clutch at Baron, as usual, as we're expecting right there. The Baron steal happens. And oh man, Keen's gonna get out of there scot-free as well. Pastry Time, we mentioned FlyQuest's Baron strats are high risk and high pace, but boy, this is the risk coming to bite them right here. They go for the suppress, and Someday coming in here, interrupting the suppression to unlock Chaser for the flash steal was awesome. So the rest of Team Dignitas then get to pile in with the ultimate from Jhin, and Keen is unleashed since the suppression was used prior. He gets a double kill on the back end, and then the rest of Fly just have to turn tail and run. That equalizes the game.
I mean, certainly does. I mean, Chaser leans back, he's dead, but he's pretty happy with himself after that steal. And the three Koreans all in sync there for Dignitas. Someday with the interrupt, Chaser with the steal, and Keen's teamfight Zed has looked incredible this series.
And they're miraculously right back in the game. FlyQuest has had so much success this year forcing plays like that, but in the series against Cloud9, it backfired. In this game, it backfired. So we're kind of seeing the other edge of the coin of these high-risk plays right there. Team Dignitas now, potentially with a little bit of driving to do, they can get the Mountain Drake, they have the Baron buff, but they still need to be more on the same page. They need to be able to react faster when FlyQuest gets them with these initiations.
Yeah, they only equalize the game with that Baron take, but they have a real opportunity to open up a lead for themselves. Someday wailing into that bottom outer turret should be able to take it and put the gold back up in Dignitas' favor, if only so slightly. turret falls down. And there's the lead for Dignitas. Pretty much neck and neck though, but these are the conversions they want. Gonna take the Mountain Drake down, look to push out the rest of these waves, and Hyah's chilling with no TP all the way in the top side of the map. Gonna try and waste as much of Dig's Baron as possible.
And you mentioned the no TP, that's the critical thing right there. They can just dive this. Someday can ignore the turret for the most part, not to mention there are Baron empowered minions. That's at least another turret going for Team Dignitas.
Hyah coming down now, but he's gonna be late to the party. Turret's gonna fall. Almost evened up that metric as well, and you can see getting ahead in gold every time they take an objective. Baron buff not up for too much longer, but they might not need that much more given that they've pretty much got themselves straight back into the game with that play.
They really have, and I said as usual when Dignitas swings the game at Baron, it usually swings in the opposite direction, so I have to credit them once again, just the ability to interrupt the Malzahar ult to the immediate flash steal from Chaser and Someday was incredibly clutch, and that just has to feel good for such an embattled team so far this split, who have been losing games at Baron, and oftentimes just not even going to Baron because they're so far behind. But now, they are right back in this game, and because of that miscue by FlyQuest, have the chance to take the series 2-0 if they can somehow pull this out. Plenty of game left to be played though. FlyQuest still very aggressive, very capable. I can't wait to see the end of this one.
And just to kind of fit the pace of the game, our next Drake will be an Infernal. It'll be the last one before Elder Dragon spawns. So we'll see if we have a big scuffle over that objective. Everything sort of reset itself though. Dignitas's Baron just about to wear off there. FlyQuest taking what farm they can, getting their side lanes back in order. Someday back in business in the bottom lane, they're going to get that started. So FlyQuest have also shown a strong overall macro and particularly shot calling. It's one of Hyah's strengths as a player. Have played games from behind before and looked very strong. This game is even, so we'll see which team can find a fault hole. We did have some criticism of Dignitas in the last game for not being too proactive. Mm-hmm. So we'll see if they can amp that up a little bit and find a better balance.
Yeah, and the question will also be whether they have to be proactive against this team. Because FlyQuest is so aggressive, and sometimes you may just be able to sit back with Zyra, wait for the Rengar and the Jarvan to dive you, and then just throw out all your spells and hope to kind of catch them in a trap, so to speak. Could end up being actually a good stylistic matchup for Team Dignitas, but FlyQuest, as we mentioned, so good in macro, so good in shot calling, but mostly praised for ending games quickly. They were going for the quick end 3 minutes ago, but that's the one that backfired. So now we have to see if they can pull out the long.
You can see the point where it all came crashing down. FlyQuest weren't hugely far ahead, but that Baron buff would have spiked them up to a big gold lead and likely more on top of it as well. As a result, instead, Dig steal the Baron, win the ensuing fight, and even the game back up. And now they've actually set themselves up beautifully to try for a siege here. Top lane tier 2 turret looking very indefensible.
Yeah, it's a tricky defense, but with no Baron empowered minions, the Sivir quite easily can clear the waves if he's willing to move up in range. Really just, you can see even a max range Boomerang Blade in one auto attack with the Ricochet is enough.
All right, not going to be that easy then. Dignitas, good setup, but don't have the strongest siege in comp. So they'll have to try again, likely around a new objective. Baron up in a minute 30 or so. They'll have to wait for that Infernal Drake. Hyah, I think being a nuisance for a lot of this, just picking up farm where he can, getting some waves pushing, making sure he disrupts Dignitas's plans, and if they can find a good pick, great, then they can start a 5v4 and try and push their way onto a bigger objective. But for now, they're just going to chill out. I mean, Arthak's getting strong as well. That's the other thing for FlyQuest to think about. Sure, the Malakai is a huge teamfight boon for Dignitas, yeah, but Arthak will take over fights if he's allowed to free hit.
It's very true. He needs to be able to complete that last whisper to be able to cut through the Malakai a little bit. And here comes FlyQuest, always looking for that play. Can they catch one?
Looking for Someday again. Going to get chunked down there. Damage is good, but it special flashes in. Huge turnaround from Dignitas. Whoa. Just going to turn it on its head. Bullets there from Lord Snipe. Everyone at Someday.
They're all
only
dead.
His GA.
And he comes right back up. They can't burst Someday before he can proc his Courage of the Colossus shield on everyone. And Pastry Time, this is exactly what we were talking about. FlyQuest will jump into you, but will it work? And this series, the answer has been emphatically no. And Team Dignitas with a 5-0 ace, storm up mid lane.
That was the cleanest ace I've seen in a while. Mid inhibitor broken, as Dignitas just absorb the first punch and annihilate FlyQuest.
What even happened? All of FlyQuest died at once. We're gonna watch this one more time.
Special's in there.
Special gets the root on two, but then it's gotta be the Zed. gets an EQ on about three or four people while Chaser is in there and AoEing with his W, not to mention Zyra does an immense amount of AoE damage. All the FlyQuest just kind of ran in a line towards Team Dignitas's AoE and all died.
And gave them the Baron on the end of the play. Now up in turrets, up in gold, up in Barons.
Wow.
Even in kills, which should tell you something about how this game has gone.
It's been a little bit loose, let's say. Not exactly a clean performance here by FlyQuest, and their reckless style is not pulling off clean plays against Team Dignitas right here, so they've been able to turn it around, but it doesn't look like FlyQuest is willing to relent on their attack. They, at this point, probably need to catch someone other than Sumdin. They have to catch a damage dealer, because if they're using everything on that, it's just unleashing the pain from the rest of the Team Dignitas team, and they're going for him.
Well, Keen's got a Guardian Angel on top of that QSS, so not too sure who they want to assassinate. Chaser would be a good target. They can't see him. Moon's going to spot Especially just
again.
In for it.
Especially, oh, that's
good
one.
They're going to blow him up, and there's a kill for Altec. Good ult there from Bulls. Ties in. Really wants to take down Lod. Flashes towards him, but Keen peels it off as Lod gets the kill. Chaser snared up, but he gets himself out of the way, as that's another kill on the back end for Altec. Sunday takes him down with the help from Zed. Dignitas playing it so well. Get another ace.
And now they have the Baron. They have the minions in the mid lane. And I think Team Dignitas is going to pick up the win against FlyQuest.
Certainly looks like the sweep is imminent. Sunday teleports his way in to try and finish it off. Super Minions going to help out in a big way.
Wow, what a wacky game, I'd have to say. 44 kills, FlyQuest just throwing themselves at Team Dignitas over and over again. And Team Dignitas is able to hit back emphatic.
They take their punches with ease and clean through FlyQuest in the series. Keen's Zed is good.
Yeah.
Whoa, man.
Really good. And even in that last fight, yes, they did catch Xspecial, but they dove past Altec. Altec just got wrecked by Keen as well as Sumday. And honestly, Lod, the heady Steryx Gauge pickup, that's an item you almost never see. They built double Steryx Gauge because they knew what FlyQuest was trying to do. FlyQuest was trying to burst them down and win before they react. And all they did is build a couple defensive items on each guy and just keep fighting back. FlyQuest played right into Team Dignitas time and time again.
Lod's been on the receiving end of the Draven before, so took yeah. necessary precautions this game, and just great execution at almost every step there for Dignitas. I mean, I think in a lot of ways, letting the style of FlyQuest play into them and just being defensive and playing very clean team fights. Some days,
yeah.
presence of mind on tanks for yeah. a top laner was phenomenal all series long. We've talked about all season that this guy's the Gary. He needs to step up and get everyone in the backpack and just win that way. Some days like, nope, I'll let my teammates do the rest of the work and just play as well as I can on carries. Turns yeah. out that's carrying every team fight and canceling Mazar ultimates, but I didn't say he wasn't a good player.
Yeah, and it was interesting too, right? Because sometimes during the game was way ahead of his team, and that was one of the ways that FlyQuest was getting the lead in the first place. But when all things were considered and they were able to kind of rebound within the game, his tank play was exquisite, as you said.
And I think talked about Altec was set up to carry that game on Sivir, but who's peeling for Altec in that game?
Animation should be the dude peeling for him, right? But time and time again, they were using that Malzahar ultimate to initiate instead of the Rengar Jarvan dive with the Rumble ultimate. Once Keen had the QSS as well, maybe he didn't think it was worth trying to sit back and peel, and it just did fall apart.
I don't know, man. Balls divergence from tanks.
Yep.
Not a strong showing so far. I mean, it didn't play badly on Vlad or Rumble, but it just didn't suit how the team wanted to play. If you're going to play the all-in, get some protection for the divers. Yeah.
A lot of things were really weird in this series, for sure, right? Like Balls playing the Vladimir in the Rumble instead of trying to opt into the tank picks that they found success with. The Jarvan getting picked two times into Zed and never once actually winning a 1v1 and not winning the lane by very much either. Not getting the maximum value out of the counter picks either. The new patch that we got to see, right? The LeBlanc coming through the first ban phase every single time and never getting snatched up early. A lot of really weird things happened in the series and gave us a pretty weird result with the 8th place team beating the 2nd place team.
Yeah, it gave us 2,000 assists from Xspecial and almost 100 kills, I think, in the two games back-to-back.
Much.
Which is pretty insane, given that it was a relatively clean 2-0 from Dignitas. But FlyQuest, they just didn't stop throwing themselves in, and Dignitas were like, sure, we'll take some free team fight wins. And to their credit, team fought very well together, which is Rare for a team that has cited communication and synergy issues as being their biggest blocker to becoming a great team.
Yeah, it is a meme, but they continue to say trust the process.
They do.
Even if that process involves bringing in a coach 2 days before your match against FlyQuest and getting rid of your previous leading coaching staff. So this is a new time for Team Dignitas, and it's got to be a pretty promising win, able to take down FlyQuest 2-0.
Good start to the back half of the season. Perhaps Freak is on stage, however, for an interview with the victorious Dignitas support.
Thank you very much. Great cast of the day, gentlemen. I am here with Ik Special, who first and foremost, by the way, record setter, 2010 career regular season assists. You just go for the thinking of what's going through your mind, if anything at all.
Wow, I'm old.
I am too. I'm older than you, I'm pretty sure.
Probably the same. I mean, we used to play, you know, kind of in the same era, but 2000 assists, I mean, great, but I kind of want to win more than anything. Assists, it's all right.
Well, I've got a surprise for you. You've won 4 games straight. How's that feel?
Technically, I only won 2.
Okay. Your team has.
Oh, yeah. So, it feels good. I mean, obviously, we changed some things on the back end, and things are looking better for us, and we're still trying to improve. We have a long ways to go to be at the top.
But do you think this is finally turning the corner, that Dignitas, who's expected to be a playoff-tier team, was sitting 9th for a while? You think this is finally you guys ready to go and make that top 6 at the very least?
I hope so, man. I mean, I can't say for certain, but like I feel like our season just started yesterday, and we're kind of climbing from the depths of the bottom of the LCS, but we're climbing slowly, and we just have to keep winning and keep trying our best and keep improving.
It seems like you absolutely can. I want to then talk about the changes, as you alluded to. COP, of course, first and foremost, when everyone can see. Coaching for you as of about 24 hours ago. So if there's anything you can tell me about that, I understand if that's a touchy subject, but at least tell me about what being coached by COP has been like so far.
I mean, I played with COP before. He was our coach for a little bit last split as well. And COP's a cool guy. He apparently has some COP magic that, you know, it's making us win. Like, I don't know. It's COP.
I heard that at the end of Champ Select, he says, body these fools, and just like with High, it's magic, and everyone plays amazingly.
Yeah, different words, though, but the same idea.
All right, well, his push has worked out for you. Especial congratulations on the win. How are you going to do with the rest of your matches this week, then?
Well, we have Team Liquid tomorrow, and hopefully we do well against them. I mean, our team, like I said, I feel like the season just started yesterday for us. Just everything has just changed so drastically, and for us, we're trying to be really positive. We weren't going into this week thinking, let's go 4-0. We're thinking, let's try our best, keep improving, and you know, we're struggling before, and now let's just try our best to keep moving forward. And like I said, keep improving. That's really our goal this whole season. And like I said, our season just started yesterday, and thank you guys for keeping with us and not, you know, losing faith in us completely.
Absolutely. Special, thank you for the interview. Congratulations, and good luck on the 4-0 week. Over to the analysts.
Thank you very much, Freak. The unexpected 2-0 victory here from Dignitas over FlyQuest. And we're going to work through this because there's a whole lot to talk about. Jarvan comp take 2.
Yep.
But work me through the key differences between game 1 and game 2 in terms of the composition that FlyQuest built.
So the main differences here for me is the Vladimir's out. The Rumble is in for balls. Turns on a little bit earlier. You get the spell penetration. You don't have to wait for super late game, which is where everybody else spikes, is the mid game here. So they have a team that actually spikes around the same time. They brought wave clear with the Sivir, and they don't need the Karma because the Sivir ultimate will do that for them now. So they have a lot of pick potential with the Malzahar. They have more wave clear. They still have the engage, but they have a mid game power spike now.
Great. So we've refined the composition here from FlyQuest a little bit. Now I want to move into the game itself. Right off the bat, we had some really interesting jungle pathing coming out of Chaser in particular to secure the first blood in the top lane.
Yeah, so this is actually a jungle start that I think we're going to be seeing more. He got the Maokai sapling start. He starts W on Kha'Zix. And then what Someday actually does here is Someday doesn't show in lane for a little bit as we continue to roll this out. Chaser will pick this up. He'll hit level 2 with a little bit of change as well. So he'll be able to hit level 3, but it's a little bit earlier than you think. But also watch the minimap, because Someday sits at his turret. He could walk out. He's like, no, I'm not going to get vision. He shows up with a little bit of monolith missing. So what FlyQuest says is topside leash, Chaser is going buff to bottom side. Chaser does this, picks up both of those, hits level 3 off of both of the main Krugs and the little ones, saves his W for that as well for efficiency.
Yep.
Then comes here, Lucy level up right there in the top. Maokai just hit level 2. This is a 2 minute and 32 second gank. That is ridiculously early. And they orchestrated that from the get-go.
I absolutely love that. Knowing that it's going to be a pushing lane because of the rumble, right? So that's just that's a byproduct of the pick itself. Now, meanwhile, on the bottom side, while all that was happening, Moon, who actually chose the exact same jungle path, has no lane to gank because Alltech and Lemonation have pushed to the turret.
Exactly.
So just pure advantage here for Chaser. Really smart.
It's a bigger synergy where they were saying, this is how the matchup goes, communicates with the laners, and says, this is what I'm going to do. Because Moon's route puts him on the bottom side. You said it's shoved just like it was. He also finishes the Krugs completely, so he's not going for that crazy play.
Right.
But also, that puts him on a weird side of the map for the rest of his route, because then he has to walk all the way to Wolves, all the way to Blue.
Right.
So if he doesn't get anything on that bottom side.
Inefficient if you're not going for the gank.
Exactly.
Efficient if you are. So great play, very smart, intelligent play out of Chaser. Now, although they secured first blood, we saw FlyQuest get out to the lead through the mid game, up until Baron Steel. So Chaser making his return here in the game to even them back up.
And that was a necessary Baron Steel. That was something that was really big. And so we'll talk about this fight here, because it's the one where it looks like it's actually going to go FlyQuest's way. A great equalizer ends up coming down across the fight, but it actually gets moved out of the way. And then just everybody gets blown up here. And I think this once again comes back to the fact that Dignitas, they were behind before the Baron Steel. Baron got stolen. A low wave clear composition that they have on Dignitas' side, well, pretty much would have been game for FlyQuest.
Absolutely.
They would have shoved you into turrets. That's even gold. Now you have actual equal footing. You play out the team fight. Equalizer, I thought it was the previous one. It's not. That one was not very good in that fight, and they didn't layer their abilities correctly for FlyQuest. So Dignitas walk away with that fight and the win.
Clutch smite into clutch fight into the victory for them, of course. When it comes to player of the game, Keen's going to be picking this one up. Yet again, Zed into the Jarvan. Picked it blind both times, right? So that's the big thing, as we know that Hai has a huge champion pool, and he could have swapped it up on him. He's playing that Zed, no fear, into whatever FlyQuest has to bring.
Yeah, and that's the thing is, Keen, he made his own plays, whereas everybody else on Dignitas, they were operating as a unit. So they were able to have that where Keen dives the backline, and then the rest of them are really synergizing, really gelling, especially at a few moments where he was caught out. But I do think that Someday was a big kind of leader here, leading the charge, because he was the person who got the interruption on the suppression. So
yep.
Chaser come over the wall. He's 70 CS up over the Rumble, who's the magic damage in the composition. So you can start building armor a little bit more than actually prioritizing magic resistance in your matchup. So I think overall, there's a lot of work here from Chaser, Someday, and then also Keen.
I mean, he also had to, you know, level W at level 2 there on Maokai. So props for that, right?
All planned. All planned.
All right, but we do have to recognize the fact that X-Special did pick up his 2,000th career assist, up to about 210 now overall. What a milestone, though. And as he mentioned, it makes him feel old, but it just speaks to the longevity of his career.
Yeah, been relevant for a very long time, but also, is this him coming back into the spotlight, right? Because there was also a sub that they used last week, Stunt. They were saying, hey, X-Special, you know, if you don't get it together, then you might not even hit 2,000 kills.
Right.
Or 2,000 assists, sorry.
No stranger to being in a position where, you know, or to having rises and peaks and valleys in his career. Confident, though, that he might be able to dig himself out of this one. And the performance today was pretty great. The Thresh game was stellar.
Yeah, he actually was kind of my front runner for player of the game on that one, because his exhausts were really good. He got the locket, he actually used it appropriately, and then he had a really good disengage a few times in that game.
All right, last thing I want to hit real quickly is the fact that Dignitas did 2-0 FlyQuest, and we haven't really talked about the fact that they just took down the second place team, right? So what's our opinion here of Dignitas on their kind of return to dominance in just this Friday night?
It's a strange thing because it's so hard to pull a lot from this series because the picks are just so strange. That doesn't look like FlyQuest playing an actual just real composition, right? And I'll say it right there, because that was all over the place. Jarvan mid twice, nothing to really wave clear effectively, no control mage, nothing like that. They moved balls off of tanks, which was working for them. Granted, his rumble is historically quite good, but it's still not something that they were able to leverage in these games.
The series might have an asterisk next to it that says, what would have happened if FlyQuest just played a normal composition, right?
Yeah,
but, to a degree.
Yeah, but I will say Dignitas in that scenario seemed like they had more teamwork.
Yep.
Seemed like nobody was getting tilted. And I think those are two pluses you can definitely take away as they climb a little bit higher in the standings, because it's necessary. They are right near the bottom. And, you know,
that's a big win over a top-tier team there. We'll see if they can go ahead and push that momentum forward. If that series was not enough for you, don't worry, because we got more league action coming your way when we return. Envy, take to the stage versus Phoenix One. Don't touch that browser.